Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Friday of the third week of Lent. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Among the gods, there is none like you, O Lord. For you are great and do marvelous deeds. You alone are God.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Pour your grace into our hearts, we pray, O Lord, that we may be constantly drawn away from unruly desires and obey by your own gift the heavenly teaching you give us. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Hosea. Thus says the Lord, "Return, O Israel, to the Lord your God. You have collapsed through your guilt. Take with you words and return to the Lord. Say to him, forgive all iniquity, and receive what is good, that we may render as offerings the bullocks from our stalls. Assyria will not save us, nor shall we have horses to mount. We shall say no more, our God, to the work of our hands, for in you the orphan finds compassion. I will heal their defection, says the Lord. I will love them freely, for my wrath is turned away from them. I will be like the dew for Israel. He shall blossom like the lily. He shall strike root like the Lebanon cedar, and put forth his shoots. His splendor shall be like the olive tree, and his fragrance like the Lebanon cedar. Again they shall dwell in his shade and raise grain. They shall blossom like the vine, and his fame shall be like the wine of Lebanon. Ephraim, what more has he to do with idols? I have humbled him, but I will prosper him. I am like a verdant cypress tree. Because of me you bear fruit. Let him who is wise understand these things. Let him who is prudent know them. Straight are the paths of the Lord. In them the just walk, but sinners stumble in them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, "I am the Lord your God, hear my voice."
I am the Lord your God, hear my voice.
An unfamiliar speech I hear. I relieved his shoulder of the burden. His hands were freed from the basket. In distress you called, and I rescued you.
I am the Lord your God, hear my voice.
Unseen, I answered you in thunder. I tested you at the waters of Meribah. Hear my people, and I will admonish you. O Israel, will you not hear me?
I am the Lord your God, hear my voice.
There shall be no strange god among you, nor shall you worship any alien god. I, the Lord, am your God, who led you forth from the land of Egypt.
I am the Lord your God, hear my voice.
If only my people would hear me, and Israel walk in my ways, I would feed them with the best of wheat, and with honey from the rock I would fill them.
I am the Lord your God, hear my voice. Verse before the Gospel. Glory and praise to you, O Christ. Repent, says the Lord. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Glory and praise to you, O Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
One of the scribes came to Jesus and asked him, "Which is the first of all the commandments?" Jesus replied, "The first is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. The scribe said to him, "Well said, teacher, you are right in saying, 'He is one, and there is no other than He,' and to love Him with all your heart, with all your understanding, with all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself, is worth more than all burnt offerings and sacrifices." And when Jesus saw that he answered with understanding, he said to him, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." And no one dared to ask him any more questions. My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And of course, we are very familiar with this gospel. And of course, for us, parang automatic na sa atin, alam natin that these are the two greatest commandments. So to love God with everything and above everything, no? And then the second commandment is to love our neighbor as ourselves, no? Of course, we need to appreciate again the context of this conversation between the scribe or the expert of the law. During the time of the Lord, there were two tendencies, no, in terms of the interpretation of the law. There were people who would multiply the precepts and the rules and regulations. Kumbaga ngayon yan sa mga batas natin, yan yung mga implementing rules and regulations, ano? And so the tendency was either to expand the rules and regulations, and then the other tendency was the exact opposite. It was to, in a sense, compress, no, and synthesize everything in one or few statements, no? And when you trace the history of the tradition of the law in the Old Testament, remember, as we were talking about this last week, the two great traditions in the Old Testament were the prophets and then the law, no? Moses represented the law. Elijah was a representative of the prophets, as we saw in the Transfiguration two Sundays ago. Anyway, here, in fact, in the history, Moses received over 1,000 precepts all in all, no? And then eventually through the generations in the Old Testament, that was reduced more and more, no? David reduced it, and then eventually it became less and less, no? And here you have now the Lord summarizing it in the two great commandments, no? But when you think about it, really, it is the great commandment of love, no, that on which the Lord centers everything. And if you also really reflect on these laws really represent a core value of our Christian faith. And I think that is what all laws should be, no? Lahat ng batas dapat, ano, yun yung kanyang sinasalamin. Ano ba yung ating pinakamahalagang, pinagpapahalagahan natin na pinaka, nasa buod, ano, nasa kaibuturan ng ating mga puso? What is that core value that we hold close to our hearts and our soul? And most certainly, it is the value of love, no? I think we go back to part of that concept of the law, that really the law defines our core values, yes, but also the law defines our springs from our fundamental relationship with God. Remember what we've reflected on in previous masses, that ang law ay nagsimula doon sa kasunduan ng Diyos sa kanyang chosen people. Ako ang inyong Diyos, kayo ang aking sambayanan. I will be your God, you will be my people. That was a fundamental agreement. That was the covenant, no? And then eventually everything was built on that, no? That was the fundamental principle, so to speak, no? And then they built the laws on that. It was to express that relationship with God. So, pagdating na ngayon kay Kristo, makikita mo na binalik na naman niya doon kung saan pinagmulan yung batas, ano? Yung pagmamahal ng Diyos at pagmamahal natin sa Diyos at pagmamahal natin sa isa't isa. So he brings it back again to that where it all started, that relationship with God. And here he defines it very, very, in a sense, very, very clearly, very, very meaningfully, to love God with everything that we've got and above everything. And of course, to love our neighbor as ourselves, no? And for me, that is really And it will last us a lifetime to constantly reflect on that and to constantly try to live that in our lives. No? So let me end by sharing a story. No? Because, here as we approach Holy Week, again, I hope that our prayer and the grace that we will pray for as we come closer and closer to Holy Week is that we may, of course, we may see Christ in this Lenten journey, but as we come closer to this Holy Week, that we may also love Him more dearly, seeing how much He loves us. No? That ultimately it is this relationship of love that will also invite us to follow Him more closely in the path of the mystery of the cross and resurrection. But let me end with a story. It's one of my favorite stories from Father de la Costa. No? According to Father de la Costa, Ignatius, every time, remember Ignatius became the head of the Jesuits, same naging kauna-unahang superior general ng mga Jesuits. Si Ignatius, ang gusto niya magbigay ng retreats, magbigay ng talks, magkaroon ng spiritual conversation. But because of his fidelity to duty, he had to stay in his office kasi he was the head. So he had to be the administrator and he had to really fix, ayusin niya yung constitution, yung mga rules, etc. and everything, no? Pag nagkaroon siya ng pagkakataon, lumalabas siya para mag-carry ng spiritual conversation, to preach, to save souls, as he would love to put it, no? And then, meron siyang isang parang alalay, si Pedro de Ribendeñera, kasi pilyo yon. So, kasakasama niya, no? Bata pa yung seminarista, lagi siyang niloloko. One time, according to Father de la Costa's story, nung nagpipreach Ignatius, tinanong niya si Pedro de Ribendeñera, "Pues Pedro, que haremos a Dios? What can we do for God?" Siyempre, hindi makasagot yung batang seminarista. Ito yung big boss, no? And then he said, "Nothing. But what can we attempt to do for God? Everything." And I think I leave that with you to think about as we come closer to Lent. Because I think that is the limit and yet that is the power of our love for God. What can we do for God? Nothing. And yet, out of love for Him, we will do everything. We will try to do everything. I think in a sense, that is for me, what is partly the message of the gospel for today. That you must love God with everything and above, with everything that we've got and above everything that there is. What can we do for God? Nothing. But what can we attempt to do for God? Everything. Everything. And for me, that is what counts to the Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord Jesus teaches us the love of God, and neighbor is the first and greatest of all the commandments. May we be loving in words, but most of all in our deeds. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In times of emergency, danger, and calamity, may the shepherds of the church have the courage to go out to the sick and the hard-pressed and to accompany health workers, rescuers, and volunteers in the hard work they are doing. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May government officials show genuine love and concern for their constituents by promoting justice and peace and by attending to the needs of the poor, the marginalized, and the oppressed. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May husband and wife give each other a Christ-like love, not seeking one's own good, but being genuinely concerned about the other's well-being. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, let us never forget to thank you for loving us with an everlasting love, a love that never varies or changes. May we, in turn, become your heart that loves and serves our brothers and sisters. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, let us never forget that in the evening of our lives, you will judge us with the criterion of love. For love sums up all your commandments, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, let our love be sincere. May we hate what is evil and cling to what is good. May we be devoted to you and to one another in love. Amen. by the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer, fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands. They will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we dedicate, that they may be pleasing in your sight and always be salutary for you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 virus that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers, that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us.
And let us pray. May your strength be at work in us, O Lord, pervading our minds and bodies, that what we have received by participating in this sacrament may bring us the fullness of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Just some announcements. On Sunday, the 14th, there will be a Mass of the Pope from St. Peter's Basilica to celebrate the 500 years of Christianity in the Philippines. So that's 10 a.m. Rome time, so that's 5 p.m. here in the Philippines. I'm sure that it will be online and probably some of the cable channels will carry it. So please, again, we encourage you to join. Even if you go to Mass already, please join, at least to be in union with the Universal Church as we commemorate our 500 years. And then also this weekend, Journeys of Hope will have part two of that preparation for prayer, especially for Holy Week. And as I mentioned yesterday, we will also have a recollection, a Triduum talks on Holy Week, Holy Thursday, Good Friday, and Holy Saturday, no, as Easter, the Easter talk. So that will be in the cable channels and online. So we will give you the more detailed schedule. Again, have a good weekend ahead, and thank you.
Kapwa ko, pananagutan ko, kailangan po namin ang inyong tulong. Panawagan po ng Catholic Bishops Conference of the Philippines, Lenten Ale Kapwa Program. Pagpalain po kayo ng poong may kapal.